Namaste and welcome back to our online mathematics class. Last class we have discussed exercise 6.1 of NCERT class 11 mathematics test. In this session we shall discuss the remaining questions from exercise 6.1. Let me start with question number 21.
Ravi obtained 70 and 75 marks in the first two unit tests. Find the minimum marks he should get in the third test to have an average of at least 60 marks. Okay, so Ravi obtained 70 and 75 marks in first two unit test. We have to find the minimum mark he should get in the third test in order to attain an at least 60 marks average. Okay, so here we can take the marks in the third test be x. Okay, let the mark in the third test be x. We know how to find average. Average means sum of observations divided by number of observations. Okay, so here 70 plus 75 and in the third test it is x divided by 3. Average is at least 60. At least you can use the symbol greater than or equal to. At least or minimum. We have to use the inequality symbol greater than or equal to. If it is at most or maximum, we can use less than or equal to symbol. These two things you have to remember. Okay, here at least, so you have to use the symbol greater than or equal to at least 60 marks. 60. Okay, minimum 60 marks. Here we can add these two numbers, 70 plus 75, 145, then plus x, greater than or equal to, this 3 we can cross multiply, 60 into 3, 190. X is greater than or equal to 180 minus 145. X is greater than or equal to 35.
So what we can conclude is, in order to attain an average of at least 60 marks, he should get greater than or equal to 35 marks in the third test. Okay.
Therefore, Ravi should get 35 or more marks in the third test.
Okay. Now the next question is,
to receive grade A in a course, one must obtain an average of 90 marks or more in 5 examinations each of 100 marks. If Sunita's marks in first 4 examinations are 87, 92, 94 and 95, find minimum marks that Sunita must obtain in 5th examination to get grade A in the course.
Okay, here also we can take the marks in 5th examination be x.
Let Sunita's marks in 5th examination be x. We can write the average as 87 plus 92 plus 94 plus 95 plus x divided by 5 greater than or equal to. Here it is 90 or more. Okay, so greater than or equal to 90. Here we can add 87, 92, 94 and 95 and we get 368 plus x greater than or equal to 90 into 5, 450. Our x is greater than or equal to 450 minus 368. X is greater than or equal to 82. So we can conclude Sunita must obtain 82 or more marks in the 5th examination to attain grade A in the course. Okay.
Now we move on to question number 23. Find all pairs of consecutive odd positive integers, both of which are smaller than 10, such that their sum is more than 11. So here we have two consecutive odd positive integers. Let it be x and x plus 2. Okay. So let x and x plus 2 be two consecutive odd positive integers. And given that the numbers are smaller than 10, so we can write x is less than 10 and x plus 2 is also less than 10. Next condition is sum is more than 11. So x plus 2 is greater than 11. We can solve this inequality. X plus x is 2x. 2x plus 2 is greater than 11. 2x is greater than 11 minus 2. 2x is greater than 9. X is greater than 9 by 2. X is greater than 4.5. Now we can write the pairs of odd positive integers, consecutive odd positive integers. We know the odd positive integer after 4.5 is what? 5. Okay. So one of the pair we can write it as 5 comma, next odd number is 7. 5 is 7. The next pair is 7 comma 9. We can't write 9 comma 11 because x and x plus 2 are less than 10. So these are the required numbers. Okay. The next question is, find all pairs of consecutive even positive integers, both of which are larger than 5, such that their sum is less than 23. Here also we can proceed as in the previous question. Let the consecutive even positive integers be x and x plus 2. Okay. So let x and x plus 2 be two consecutive even positive integers, both of which are larger than 5. So we can write, given x is greater than 5 and x plus 2 is also greater than 5. And the next condition is their sum is less than 23. Sum is less than 23. So x plus 2 is less than 23. X plus x is 2x. 2x plus 2 is less than 23. 2x less than 23 minus 2. 2x is less than 21. X is less than 21 by 2. And x is less than 10.5. Now we can write the pairs of consecutive even positive integers which satisfies the conditions. Okay. X is less than 10.5 and x is more than 5. So next even positive integer after 5 is 6. Okay. So the pair is 6 comma 8. The next pair is 8 comma 10. And the next pair is 10 comma 12. Okay. Now we move on to question number 25. The longest side of a triangle is 3 times the shortest side, and the third side is 2 cm shorter than the longest side. If the perimeter of the triangle is at least 61 cm, find the minimum length of the shortest side. Okay, so here we can take the shortest side as x. So let the length of the shortest side be x. Now we can write the other sides. Longest side. It is given that the longest side of a triangle is 3 times the shortest side. Shortest side we take it as x. So 3 times x, that is 3x. And the third side.
third side is 2 cm shorter than the longest side. Here the longest side is 3x and the third side is 2 cm shorter than the longest. That is 3x minus 2. Clear? And the next condition is perimeter of the triangle is at least 61. At least we can use the symbol greater than or equal to. So perimeter is given that greater than or equal to 61. We know the perimeter is what? Sum of all the three sides of the triangle. Okay. So here we can write x plus 3x plus 3x minus 2 is greater than or equal to 61. X plus 3x is what? 4x. 4x plus 3x is 7x. So 7x minus 2 is greater than or equal to 61. 7x is greater than or equal to 61 plus 2. 7x is greater than or equal to 63. And from this we can write x is greater than or equal to 63 divided by 7. And x is greater than or equal to 9.
Okay, that means the length of the shortest side is 9 or more than 9. Okay,
so we can conclude. Therefore, the length of the shortest side is greater than or equal to 9 cm.
Okay. Now we move on to the last question in this exercise. A man wants to cut 3 lengths from a single piece of board of length 91 cm. The second length is to be 3 cm longer than the shortest and the third length is to be twice as long as the shortest. What are the possible length of the shortest board if the third piece is to be at least 5 cm longer than the second? So here we can take the length of the shortest board as x. Okay. Let x be the length of the shortest board. So length of the second piece, we can write it as 3 cm longer than the shortest. So length of the second piece equal to x plus 3. Okay. And the length of the third piece of board will be equal to, third length is twice as long as the shortest, that is 2x. And we are given two sets of conditions. First one is the total length of the piece is 91 cm. From this we can write x plus 3 plus 2x is less than or equal to 91. Okay. And the another set of condition is the last one. The third piece is to be at least 5 cm longer than the second. Third piece. Length of the third piece we take it as 2x. At least. So greater than or equal to 5 cm longer than the second. Second piece is of length x plus 3. So x plus 3 plus 5. I repeat. The total length of the board is what? 91 cm. So we can write x plus 3 plus 2x is less than or equal to 91. That means the maximum length is what? 91. That's why we use the symbol less than or equal to. Okay. And the second condition is the length of the third piece is to be at least 5 cm more than the second. So 2x is the length of the third piece. That is 2x is at least, that is greater than or equal to 5 cm longer than the second. Here the second piece is of length x plus 3. So x plus 3 plus 5. Now we have to solve these two inequalities simultaneously. Okay. We can solve it one by one. X plus x 2x, 2x plus 2x is 4x.
4x plus 3 is less than or equal to 91. 4x is less than or equal to 91 minus 3. And 4x is less than or equal to 88. X is less than or equal to 88 divided by 4. Therefore, x is less than or is equal to 22. Okay. And in the next one, 2x greater than or equal to x plus 8. 2x minus x is greater than or equal to 8. Or x is greater than or equal to 8. We can combine these two conditions. First one, x is less than or equal to 22. Second one, x is greater than or equal to 8. So we can write, therefore, 8 less than or equal to x less than or is equal to 22.
Therefore, we can conclude the length of the shortest body is greater than or equal to 8 but less than or equal to 22. 8 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 22. Okay, so this finishes exercise 6.1. Thanks for watching. Thank you.